First, my obedience to God, bring us to church, to our pastors, the men on the pulpit, ministers, and associate ministers, members of Asia, my brothers and sisters in Christ, and our visiting guests. It is my honor and pleasure to have been asked to give words of encouragement to our pastor on his 10th year anniversary. Now, he's brought the word. Well, about what I'm going to say. It's okay. I'm going to keep you clean today. But it has been a pleasure being a member of Asian Baptist Church under the watch care of Reverend Thibodeau. And so my eyes have failed me over the years. They started before you got this. I'm not blaming you for that. But so we're going to try to read this. But I'm going to try to do this without looking at most of my notes. So when I was asked a few days ago by Reverend Thibodeau to do this, he sent me an email, you know, in the modern age. He sent me an email instead of calling me on the phone. But I probably wouldn't have answered. But he sent me an email and he said, "Are you going to be there Sunday?" So yesterday was the 70th anniversary, the 70th birthday, anniversary birthday. And so we had a little celebration at the house. And so when he asked me, I said, "Oh, I don't know after the party. I don't know if I'll be there." But because he asked, and because I love my pastor, I'm here. And actually, I got the interview on him too. and my son and daughter are here. So I started looking for things that I wanted to say about Reverend Thibodeau as he recognizes his year. And I came across a couple of things. And one of them was about the Good Shepherd. And it talks about this church or the sheep looking for or needing someone to guide them. And you know, we were under the leadership of Reverend Bridges for many, many years. And as things happen, you know, people get older and you just move forward. And so as you're getting ready, Reverend Bridges said, "I'm going to retire and we're getting ready to try to find someone." And the Lord, long before that, put Timothy Thibodeau first in the choir. Then he brought him down here. And Reverend Bridges started letting him preach. And he got pretty good. And, you know, the members started saying, "Oh, you can listen to people who are out there." So I don't know, Reverend Bridges must have heard that and he decided to make Reverend Thibodeau the pastor, help us pastor as our pastor. And so I think that God sent, in place of Reverend Bridges, as a shepherd. And that's the Reverend Thibodeau. He watches over his flock. He cares about us. Yes. He understands us in our moments of weakness, our moments of meanness, our moments of goodness, and he loves us during all of that. And I think that one cannot ask for a pastor any greater than that, who loves his members no matter what their failings are. Understanding that all of us are just human. And we're trying to do the right thing so that we can make it to glory. And so, as we recognize him, I want to do a couple of things, and I hope not to be too long, but I want to talk about the responsibility of a pastor. And I've said some of that. But the responsibility of a pastor is to lead the church, regardless of what the members want. His responsibility and his answer is to God. And so, he's got to do what says the Lord. Yes. Not what the people of the church necessarily want, necessarily like. Yes. It is his job to tell us right and wrong, and it is our responsibility, having been set by God, it is our responsibility to listen to what he says and try to do what he is asking us to do as we build the church family, as we go out in the community to do what God would have us all to do, and that is to make disciples of men, boys and girls. So I found a boy that talks about the responsibility of pastors, if I can't see that, I'm not over here. But we know that pastors have a special call. They're alive on their lives, and they need to be encouraged, cherished, and appreciated as much as possible. And so the question for us today, are we doing everything that we can in every way to appreciate our pastor? Not just on today, but every day of the week, every day of the month, every month of the year. Are we doing everything to appreciate the pastor? So just a little exclamation point, a simple poem. It doesn't mean you know, bringing them their gifts. It doesn't mean that. Do we appreciate a special message? Do we tell him after service on Sunday that that was a good message? It touched my heart. It meant something to me. Do we just go in and say, have a good day? Do we go in and say, is there anything that you need? Now, you know, I don't know if you tell you this, but every now and then I bring them a little gift too. Because years ago, before Katrina, I made this peanut soup that he liked. And after Katrina, he's like, okay, bring me some soup. Well, as you know, Katrina started lots of things, and there went my peanut soup recipe. So I've been trying to find this peanut soup recipe, and I bring a different version every now and then. He's like, no, that's not it. No, that's not it. But I think he's forgotten what it really was. He's going to bring one and say, what they did to me. But then I brought other kinds of soup. I brought corn soup. The other thing I want to do is just give him, and I know he knows these, we all know these, seven Bible verses that are encouraging to him. The first one is Isaiah 40:31. For they who wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings like eagles. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint. Jeremiah 2:15. And I will give you shepherds after my own heart, who will feed you with knowledge and understanding. 1 Corinthians 15:58. Therefore, my beloved brothers, be steadfast, immovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord, knowing that in the Lord your labor is not in vain. Galatians 6:9. And let us not grow weary of doing good, for in due season we will reap if you do not give up. Philippians 4:19. And my God will supply every need of yours according to his riches and glory in Jesus Christ. 1 Timothy 5:18. For the scripture says, you shall not muzzle an ox when it treads out the grain, and the laborer deserves his wages. Hebrews 13:7. Obey your leaders and submit to them, for they are keeping watch over your soul. As those who have to give an account, let them do this with joy and not with groaning, for that will be of no advantage to you. In closing, I found this poem entitled You Are My Pastor, so by Tom Rainer. So I did a little bit of tweaking it to make it fit. But so it says, you are my pastor. You are our pastor. You are not perfect. You get frustrated like everyone else. You don't always say exactly what you should say or what you want to say. You do indeed make some mistakes. On that reality,